Courage is not the absence of fear. It is actually feeling that fear. I'm gonna look old. I don't wanna go through this gray out process, and you do it anyway. So let me know in the comments if you are on a gray hair journey, if you're thinking about going gray, how long you've been dye free. Let me know if you agree in the comments with a thumbs up, yes or a no. Do you think these are the top two fears that you dealt with or are dealing with in your mind about going gray? One of them is I'll look old, and the grow out process. One of the things that I want you to keep in mind, what this dye free going gray journey has taught me is self-acceptance. Being able to accept all of me, where I am, how I am. And this reminds me of my mom's quote. She had mentioned, you have to look forward, not backward, with acceptance for where you are in life. And my mom is Maggie. If you didn't see that my last video, please go check that out. I'll be putting it in the description after this. But in that video, my mom talked about that's what the biggest thing that she learned from her gray hair journey is. And she mentioned to me how, you know, at first she's like, it's just gray hair. What's the big deal? Stop dyeing it. You know, that's how she treated it at first. But she said, when my sister had chopped her hair when she was going through the natural part of the process, she realized, wow, you know, she looked at herself in the mirror and she really started to see some things. Like I mentioned, it can trigger some stuff underneath that you may not have realized from before. And so she was able to realize, you know what, I can't look backward anymore. I have to look forward. The graceful fact that there are some points in the journey that we will not like and we can't skip, and we'll be better for going through it. I think that that's true whether you're on a gray hair journey, whether you're on a weight loss journey, motherhood journey, right? So tell me in the comments if you've had certain things in your life where you were like, you couldn't skip it, you couldn't go above it or under it, you had to go through it. And at the time, you don't necessarily feel like you'll be better for it. But afterwards, when you look back in hindsight, you're like, you know what? I learned something from this. And this reminds me also of a quote by Brené Brown. She says, you can choose courage over comfort. You cannot have both. Sometimes that can be a hard pill to swallow. I don't want to tell you when you're on your gray hair journey that you got to grit and bear it, and that there aren't ways that you can't find to make it smoother or easier. That is the goal of my channel, to give you some tools to be more compassionate to yourself for the challenges, not necessarily to avoid the challenges, but to get through the challenges a lot easier. Let me know if you guys agree with this quote from Brené Brown, that you can't have both. You can't be courageous and then comfortable at the same time, because courage is not the absence of fear. It is actually feeling that fear. I'm gonna look old. I don't wanna go through this gray out process, and you do it anyway. And many of you have contacted me and let me know that because of this time that we're living in right now, you're taking advantage of being at home, working from home, and you're growing out your hair. You don't have the opportunity, you know, it's out of your control to be able to go and get your hair done the way you usually do. So you're now thinking about letting this process happen. It might have been something that was going on in your mind that you were like, and then now this time period that we're in kind of pushed you through that. So because of that, that's why I wanted to go over the second one today, because sometimes I feel like maybe some of you are like, okay, I get the old part. I'm just going to embrace this. I'm going to do this. But now you're like, oh, that grow out process, what's that going to be like? Do I have to deal with the differing colors? And I did do a video giving you guys some options on different hairstyles that you can do while you're going through the grown gray process. Maybe some of you are not natural, some of you who are watching this, so you're like, I don't do braids, or I don't do turbans or scarves. Maybe some of you, because of where you work, you're not able to do those things. So I will tell you, I cut my hair, I did a big chop because I wanted to not have as much colored hair to have to grow through. That was my choice. It doesn't have to be yours. But as you do that, you will find that Like, I couldn't even escape it. Even though I didn't have a lot of colored hair to grow through, I still had my own, my hair was very short. I still had to grow through that. But I will say that deciding to go gray and cutting my hair in a tapered cut, I started to appreciate a tapered style and having a shape to my hair. So that was a gift that came from this. So here's a graceful tip. Okay, you can think of something that you do love about yourself, how you look, something that can give you a feeling of empowerment and not like, okay, so am I just supposed to just take this lying down, you know, with this whole differing colors and things like that. If you have natural hair, I think textured styles can help hide those roots maybe in the beginning. If you have a gray halo, like I said, there's some headband styles that you could think of. But I didn't do that when I went gray. I didn't wear any headbands. It was just all out there for everyone to see. My mom even mentioned that there were some who stared at her because she went through that two-tone skunk stage too. So I hope it gives you comfort to know that if you are going through that and you are dealing with some differing colors, let me know in the comments if you are, that you're not alone. You know, there are others of us who have gone through the same thing. So maybe you're into makeup. Can you try some different colors? Maybe you're into clothing or fashion. Can you do something else that kind of makes you feel good? Can you wear some jewelry? Just trying to find things to help it to be smoother. But as I said in the previous slide, there are some points that you're not going to be able to skip when it comes to the gray hair journey. But it's also comforting to know that it won't last forever. Look at me. I'm 3 years in. It has gone by way faster than I thought it would go. And you'll be on the other side of it and you'll be happy that you did. You know, the sooner you start, the sooner you can get through that most awkward stage of the grow out. Here's an affirmation that you can tell yourself. An affirmation is basically a true statement that can make you feel empowered. Speaking truth to yourself, basically. You can tell yourself, I can tolerate the discomfort that comes with change. Because that's another thing that this gray hair journey represents. It represents change, which is not easy. You know, we're going through a change, all of us right now. We're sharing it together, a change in how our world is, you know, right? And, you know, whether we resist it or not, it's going to happen. And that's the thing about reality. There's a certain peace that you can experience when you stop resisting what is happening and you just learn to accept it. And sometimes it can feel, I definitely am not one to deny someone's feeling and, you know, saying that you're going to like it. You know, like, oh, you're going to like your hair being in all different colors, or that your hair, doesn't look like this other gray hair person's hair that you love. But at the same time, the sooner you accept it, the sooner you'll have peace. And then the sooner you'll be able to look for things that you can be grateful for. Like I said, with me, it helped me to appreciate that I love a shaped style as opposed to letting my hair grow. So I would love for you guys to let me know in the comments what you thought of some of those tips, what suggestions you would give, because this is a collaborative effort. You guys are just as helpful with your own journeys. There was someone either in the comments or email, which I appreciate so much, you guys even sending me pictures of your hair and what it looks like. I'm so excited to see that because I could live your journey through you. But there are many who have learned a lot from this, and there are things they wish they knew before, but by you sharing it now in the comments, it could be able to help someone who's in the stage that they're at now. So to recap, there are certain parts in the journey that are difficult to deal with, but it can teach you acceptance. Remember this quote, that you can choose courage over comfort. You cannot have both. So there are certain things that you can't control, but focusing on what you can leave you feeling a little bit more empowered from this. Another thing that you guys have been asking me about that I can give tips. My sister gave products and things that my mom used, but at the end of the day, there are certain things that you guys may deal with because we all, our hair is different, that we have to accept. Any questions that you have or videos, many of you have already done that and I appreciate it very much. It helps me to know what content to make for you guys, to for it to be informative and practical. Thank you so much for coming on here. I appreciate your continued support and I look forward to seeing you guys on the next video, okay? Bye.